Rebel base was now expanding. They had built out an area for barracks, and a hangar with space enough for new ships to fly in and out. They immediately got to filling this with an X-Wing and a Y-Wing, both from the Rebel Alliance. They sent pilots along with them, one of them named Buck Rogers, the other named Apollo Adama. Any similarity to names of other series is completely coincidental. They also built a supply room where they could store unusual items they had gotten from missions. And finally, they also got from Rebel Command a supply officer, and a diplomat who began speaking with members of House Elegant to win them over to the side of the rebellion. Lieutenant Wen's group was heading off on a mission on board the Krusty Minok, so it was a perfect time to try out their new ships and pilots. They were going to the Hovan system, a star orbited only by asteroids, where there were supposed to be rare minerals that the Empire was mining. These minerals were being secretly transported by the Empire, and the crew of the Rusty Minok was trying to find out why. They came out of hyperspace in an area that was most likely to carry these unusual minerals. The rocks were sliding through space unpredictably, some crashing against one another. Game note, this is a game of X-Wing where the characters have been custom made for the game, and the asteroids move randomly based on die rolls at the beginning of each turn. The Krusty Minok could scan each asteroid type when it came within a short distance of them. The fighters kept watch while they did. They detected two TIE fighters coming in from the side, so they moved to intercept. Adama and the Y-Wing coming in close to Rogers in the X-Wing to fly in a tight formation while the Krusty Minok flew out wide around one of the emerald asteroids. R5, focusing only on the scanners, found signs of the special minerals the Empire was mining. What it was, they still didn't know. But they now knew for certain its source. The two Rebel fighters engaged the TIEs, and each of them took out one of the enemies. The two fighter pilots were already getting along famously, working together to coordinate their efforts. Then two interceptors came in behind the Krusty Minok. Adama was facing away, so it was up to Rogers to intercept them both. The Krusty Minok came around a large asteroid to find an Imperial freighter parked and powered down. "Keep those ships off our back," Lieutenant Wen called. "We're going in for a look." As they moved in, they spotted two bombers coming at them. They took out the Krusty Minok's shields, but Puck fired back, using his ability to roll an extra die at close range, doing a massive amount of damage to one of the bombers, and now the Y-Wing was diving in, finishing it off. Rogers, meanwhile, was having to deal with both interceptors on his own. He spent most of his time dodging and remaining hidden behind asteroids. The last bomber purposely missed the Krusty Minok and hit the asteroid next to it. Puck didn't understand his choice, especially since it seemed that the Imperial ship had been mining it. But it didn't matter. He wanted to shoot it down, so he fired into it, doing plenty of damage, but still not destroying it. Now Rogers came screaming through, passing the Y-Wing where they formed up again. The Y-Wing shot its ion cannon at the oncoming interceptor, and Rogers pursued the one in front of him, sandwiching it between himself and the YT-2000. Davith, piloting the ship, reached out into the Force, which showed him the weakness of the fighter. Acting on faith, Davith told Puck where to shoot, and he did, destroying it! Davith then brought the ship into dock with the Imperial freighter so he and Wen could board the ship. It would be all up to their pilots to clear the space around them. Wen got into the enemy ship first, and she found some droids pulling apart some asteroids they had brought on board. Davith arrived behind her, and with the backup, she fired at the droid, damaging it. The one she hit fled, but two others came around corners and began firing at her, sending her for cover. Davith charged out and destroyed one of them, then started at the other. Outside, Adama was covering the rear against the remaining interceptor, making it helpless with his ion cannon, and Rogers was going after the bombers. He damaged one severely, and Puck destroyed it. Four more TIE fighters were coming in behind them. "I think it's time to leave," Adama said. "I'd be obliged to agree," Rogers said. "Roger that," Puck said. "Huh?" Rogers said. "Lieutenant, you ready to get out?" Wen ran in and grabbed the asteroid, while Davith deflected incoming shots. "Almost back! Cover us until then!" "We may not be able to if you're much longer," Puck said. A bunch of enemy fighters were on the long-range scanners. Davith detected them with his Jedi skills, and he pulled back onto the ship. R5 recognized the dire situation, and was already plugged into the controls. As soon as their crew members were on board, it closed the hatch behind them and detached. The thrusters immediately fired up, and the Krusty Minok was taking off. The TIE fighters got a couple minor hits on the fighters' shields, but they didn't amount to much as the Rebels pulled away and flew off. The other team was on its way to the neutral world of Sayamara. The capital city on this planet had the lead diplomatic buildings where all the houses met to discuss issues amongst their empires. Though officially run by the Galactic Empire, it was recognized as a world overseen by the local governments. The Rebel Commando team was here to infiltrate some of the offices of House Araba, According to the royal prisoner they had taken, the Empire had secret offices hidden within the bowels of this building, and they were organizing some sort of strange operation that not even high-ranking members of the houses approved of them doing. The rebels had garnered enough information from their prisoner and from Jarn's mind scans to get an idea of what they would need to wear to fit in. They had acquired workers' garb to look like a maintenance crew. Once in the building, they could let their disguises do the work to keep them incognito. Since their last mission, they had gained several skills. Mac had gained expertise, allowing him to take an additional action after interacting with anything. He had also purchased a combat coat. MHD had gained fuel injection, which allowed it to add one to its speed, and it could interrupt an opponent to go two spaces. It also got a Bacta injector, which allowed it to heal an adjacent figure. And Duke got Shout for Joy, which allowed him to scream so loud and obnoxiously that it stunned enemies. He also took Skedaddle, which allowed him to move two spaces after hitting someone. And finally, Vresh took Rampage, which caused extra stands around the Wookiee to take damage after he hit his target. They entered through the workers' entrance, a common access room not designed to impress anyone. Their mission was to learn about the connection of the Imperials to this house, so they set about searching the computer terminals while pretending to be employees. Vresh and Duke set out down the hallway to the left, covering the others, while MHD came up behind. It opened the door to a conference room, and found inside a Nugnaught near a computer terminal inside. Mac rushed past them and hurried toward the terminal on the far end. Vresh didn't have to shoot any of the Ugnaughts, so he rushed in and intimidated one of them. The Ugnaught left in a heartbeat. Duke could see that others were curiously wandering toward the conference room, and communicated that to the others. The other team members did what they could, plugging into the computer terminal and gathering what they needed. But they all found very little of use in the official records, so they moved on to the next corridor. A lift sat at one end, while a room stood on the other. The lift may be the key. So the operatives went right for it as they heard the Ugnaughts grumbling among themselves, preparing to confront this new enemy. Before they knew it, the floor dropped beneath the commando team and they fell into the level below. This one was clearly decorated by the Empire with its black and gray polished walls and extreme gradients. They weren't in House Araba anymore, Toto. Duke went out first, jumping and kicking open the door! No, just kidding. The miniature just fell over. He opened the door to find himself face to face with an officer. Duke froze a moment, expecting to be fired at, but was surprised to find the officer didn't react. He was clearly not expecting intruders. At last he looked up to see Duke there and his eyes grew wide. They grew even wider to find himself assaulted by a Wookiee, who knocked him unconscious. Vresh continued down the hall to find more officers wandering the corridors, going about their usual work. Mac went the other direction and found himself on a balcony overlooking an officer going about his work. He shot him down and readied himself for others while MHD joined Duke. Hearing the commotion, stormtroopers entered from two sides and set about finding the rebels. They could hear the Wookiee chopping away around a corner. Before they could get to him, Duke went to the corner and shouted, "Rock and roll!" and spread hits around the entryway. The others came around the opposite direction, pinching Duke in the middle. "Come back to me, Mad Dog!" his new nickname for the droid. MHD sighed and began to follow. It knew that Duke was going to get them all killed. After all, they should be backing. A door opened next to it, and two officers fired, damaging MHD. Along the other side, meanwhile, Mac was slowly sneaking around the periphery, sniping the officers. Duke screamed as he ran into the middle of the hallway, blasting every stormtrooper around him and blocking more from getting in. This was where he liked to be, in the middle of a fray, backed up by his favorite Mad Dog, get over here! He shouted.
"Nah, I don't really want to,"
MHD said, pumping in his fuel injection and speeding in among the officers. It plugged into the computer while two other arms popped out, one of them with a blade that sliced an officer's throat, the other with a blaster that shot down the second one. Duke was not faring so well. The stormtroopers surrounded him. He took cover behind the equipment in the hall, but many of the shots hit him, wounding him and flipping his card. Vresh rushed into the rescue, slicing away. Mac also came in from behind, sniping at the back troopers. Duke retreated back into the other room with MHD and the troopers focused their attention on Vresh, wounding him severely. He rushed them and took two more down, but he was taking a great deal of damage, now having to flip his card over as well. Wounded and near death, Vresh kept on fighting. Mac, meanwhile, was having to deal with the officer behind him and the other troopers who had turned back toward him. He got surrounded as well, and they were coming in for a killing blow. But then Vresh, far from defeated, leaped into the fray, taking down one, then two stormtroopers. They concentrated their fire on him, bringing him down nearly to death. Duke knew that he had to rescue his friend who had just saved him. "Come on, Mad Dog, we gotta get in there."
"No, I'm good," MHD said.
Duke shot down a trooper and insisted, "Mad Dog, we gotta get in there and save Vresh!" The computer console lit up with information. This was the wrong console. "Okay, I'm ready to go," MHD said, and it strolled through another doorway. Coming up behind the stormtrooper Duke was fighting and stabbing it in the back of the neck with a syringe. It then continued on, right past Vresh. More stormtroopers were entering, three of them near Mac, and one from the other side. Vresh began to charge at them, but MHD stopped him with its arm and injected the Wookiee with a healing salve. "Wait, this will help," it said. "So you'll heal him and not—" Duke began. But they were interrupted by the stormtroopers rushing up and shooting Mac and the droid. MHD was flipped to the wounded side, and the troopers were once again surrounding them. It was time for Vresh to smash! He chopped down two of them. Duke shot the officer near Mac in the back, and Mac shot down the remaining trooper near him. MHD hurried into the computer console to search for the information they needed. Vresh and Duke rushed the last remaining troopers and took them down. Just then, more officers and stormtroopers entered from every side. It was beginning to feel hopeless, but the rebels held them off as long as they could while MHD kept searching through the databanks. The stormtroopers rushed Mac, flipping him to the wounded side, and one pushed through to fire and damage MHD. Vresh rushed the officers and sliced through all of them, but they managed to get shots off on both him and Duke. Vresh was near death, but with his last ounces of energy, he finished off the officers. Duke shot down one of the troopers on Mac, and Mac stepped in front of the one firing at the droid, taking him down. They could hear more Imperials on their way, but MHD got the data they had come for. Vresh led the way to the exit, and the others followed. Duke turned to see them coming. It was a horde of stormtroopers, officers, and house soldiers. With all of his team members wounded, they might not make it, but they tried. He took a couple pot shots while Mac and MHD ran toward him. As the soldiers fired down the hall, Duke took it as a cue to leave, and he joined Vresh. Mac and MHD followed suit, but Mac was just a little bit behind. Three soldiers managed to get in range and fired, doling enough damage to kill Mac. But on the last shot, Mac rolled the dodge all damage result, saving his life. Rolling past, he got to the exit, and they managed to get to the ship. All of them were badly wounded, but all were still alive. And now they had information vital to learning just what was going on between the Empire and the local houses. It was a project called Lifeseed. If you enjoyed this video, please thumb us below and spread the word. Click on the next video to continue watching the story, and you can find other stories written by the author in the description below. May the Force be with you, and happy gaming, everybody.